Hello everyone. Self-confidence and confidence, both are very distinct and necessary human qualities. In order to achieve anything, obviously everybody should be self-confident and confident enough. But sadly, both these terms are taken in general and mistaken often. Now in this video, let's clarify the thin line difference between self-confidence and confidence and how important that difference is. For example, a student from long time has been rejecting to enroll for a seminar. Due to some inhibitions, due to some inferiority complex, he feels that he's not capable enough to give a seminar. Now finally, a faculty observes, decided to help, you know, quoting some good examples, motivates the student that everybody is doing, how, you know, why can't you, etc., etc. Now this motivation will give some instant reaction that is related to positivity, right? So this instant reaction will help the student to feel that, yes, I can do it, I'm capable. Now he gives the name that tomorrow I'm going to give a seminar. Now this feeling is obviously common in at least 70 out of 100 people because most of the people are positive inside. Now, what happens next? With the positivity, the student goes back to home, feels very happy that finally he's going to come out of whatever the fear he has, and he prepares some content about the topic. He comes back to the class. Finally, the time will arrive to go and perform. But after going there, the student starts feeling nervous. You know, he's inside hoping that the time should finish soon, using board unnecessarily, not facing the audience, seeing everywhere except audience, and finally giving up, saying, sorry, I'll try next time. Now this is very sad. Why the student has failed to convert the opportunity into a proper one? Why at least 50% he has failed to execute his plan? Now, the reason is this self-confidence when he got after the motivation of the faculty has not converted into confidence, because confidence requires skill, and that skill can only come through some research, some consistency, and some proper approach. Now, with the same student, after going back to home, if he had done some research about how actually a seminar should be given, some plan on the paper, that content reducing to steps, imagining some examples, that tomorrow I should quote this example, and start doing in the headspace, start doing some rehearsals, expecting some hurdles, expecting some audiences, and finally coming to the class. And when trying after this practice, the result will be more than 50%, right? So the reason most of the people fail when they try to do something, because they think the self-confidence they have inside is enough. But most of the times, it will not. Only 70 out of 100 people will go to 30 out of 100 people. And that's why self-confidence will not automatically convert into confidence. It should be nurtured. There is a bridge between self-confidence and confidence, and that bridge can be only covered with skill, with practice, and with the right process. And when people are confident, any successful people will not bother about the result. They only bother about the process. That's why we should not mistake self-confidence with confidence. Instead, we should take the promotion. Thank you for watching.